Bitterness has been tasted.
It didn't taste it.
Facebook. The title of this video is The Funeral Hustle GoFundMe. Okay, now the reason I'm making this video, of course, there's been a lot of things online about the young lady in Chicago who lost her son. People say, you know, she set up a GoFundMe account and she went and bought a car, which I don't know what she did. I don't know if she spent $500 on the down payment. I don't know if she paid for the motherfucking cash. What I know is that I did not donate any money. I didn't contribute anything, so I don't really have anything to say in regards to what she did with the money, because not a single penny of it is mine. But I do want to take this opportunity to spread some education amongst my people, and I'm going to forewarn you that the information I'm going to share with you can be disturbing to some, it can be angering to some, it may be hard to stomach, but we're going to talk about it, because a place where people waste a lot of money is on funerals. I don't ever really jump when people holler funeral. And the reason for that is I spent a significant part of my life working as a family service counselor in a funeral home. I have seen every aspect of the funeral business. I know it like the back of my hand. Okay, from scraping up your brains off the street, putting them in a bag, taking you to the corner. Once the corner give me the call, I can come pick you up. I come pick you up, clean you up, call my man in to embalm you. I dress you up, put you in the casket. Service. To the cemetery we go, burial, cover, flowers, hug your mama. That was my job. Now, let me tell you something. I was trained specifically to find out how much money you had to spend and to spend it all for you, because I collected a 30% commission. So, if you had $20,000 funeral policy, insurance policy, it was my job to try to get you to spend $20,000. Okay? So if they taught me to do this, then I'm thinking they taught everybody to do the shit. Now, I had a hard time with this after I had made some money, because I say, man, this lady's husband just died, and I just spent $15,000 on this funeral, and she can't pay her mortgage next month. See, because that's what insurance is for, to help the surviving members keep on going after that family member is gone. Now, with GoFundMe, that's different, because that's not insurance. That's asking for help. But the bottom line to this situation is, y'all, funerals are a waste of money. Hear me and hear me well. There's no such thing as an airtight casket. I have put people in the ground. A year later, the family's moving to another state. They want to take that family member with them. I make it a point to tell them they cannot be present when we exhume the body. The reason for that is because that airtight casket that I sold you wasn't really airtight. And it's actually filled with water at this point. And your loved one is in there floating around in water, deceased as can be. Okay? Do we steal jewelry? No. The jewelry will be in there floating too, or if it done came off the bones. But it gets real fucked up underground. And I'm in Las Vegas, Nevada. We barely get any rain. So if caskets are filled with water in Nevada, then imagine how much water they got in Georgia or New Orleans. I'm telling you, funerals are a waste of money. Dead is dead. And you can do a decent home going if you know what you're doing and you're not dealing with shady people for $5,000 or less, depending on how overdramatic you being. Because people in the funeral business are taught to take advantage of your emotions with a very, very plain look on our face. Something like this. Yes, ma'am. I understand. It's going to be all right. Is there going to be credit or cash? I did this every goddamn day. I didn't care if it was your baby or your grandmama. My job was to get paid. So understand this. When you're dealing with funeral home people, okay? It's about that money. It's about that money. It's about that money. And these people collect 30% commissions off of your emotions. I was very good at this. I didn't care who it was, who died, what. I had to get paid. It's a very cold-hearted man's hustle. You know what I'm saying? So just understand, when somebody get to hollering and screaming about a funeral, tell them, don't spend all that goddamn money to put in a hole in the ground. And I'm done. You do what you want to do with that information. My family know what to do with me. Peace.